Thank you very much for your invitation and your introduction too. You already gave a very good summary of ERC. We are totally faithful to the idea that we are funding research on the basis of initiative given by the researchers who are strictly bottom-up. If you allow me, I would like to make basically 3 points. The first one is that we as scientists, we have to remember all the time that we are evolving in an ecosystem which has several components, and we have to be sure that the right balance exists between these components. So of course, as president of the ERC, I very much want to make the case again, as you already made, that it's extremely important that the bottom-up part has to be very significant, and that the initiative has to be left to the researcher for a number of things. But of course, for some priority questions, for which really we know that you need some kind of more long-term massive organization, you need other approaches. So I think this, at the European level, I mean, the so-called framework program has these various pillars, as they are usually called, which associate not only research, but also innovation, which touches a point that you also discussed briefly, namely how you transform scientific results into activities which have, in the end, some economic bearing or some societal bearing. So just to continue a little bit more on this ecosystem, of course, then the other component of the ecosystem, which is absolutely vital, is of course the people, because the research is done by people, and therefore it's very important in the various countries that in particular young people have a perspective to develop research. And as you know, this is not the case in all countries where, for various reasons, either positions are not available or they have become extremely unstable, or even in some cases people feel that they are not welcome and actually they can develop their activities better elsewhere. So this component about what is offered as perspective for young people is something which I think has to be kept in mind a lot, because in this ecosystem there are of course support, finances which are given to people, but also you need the proper environment in which people can really develop their work. That was my first point on really this ecosystem. Concerning the European Research Council, as you know, I mean, we are organized. Actually, it was a long battle by the scientific community. Personally, the first time I heard about the possibility of having an ERC was 1995. So it took 12 years to get it off the ground. And there were a number of times where we're close and then getting far and then getting again. So it was a quite complicated process. Finally, it was successful. And if you look at the details, actually, there are very interesting moments, and some people played a very key role in this. And it's always interesting to look at these key moments. And some of these people were not scientists. They were political people, or they were people from really, I mean, the European Commission. And so I don't want to name anybody here, but it's very interesting. I can talk to some of you on this, because some people changed their mind at the last minute and made a big difference. So the ERC now has been in its 11 years of existence, and I think it has been really endorsed by the scientific community very well. Just to give one example, last year we celebrated 10 years of ERC, and we offered the possibility to all institutions who wanted to organize a small celebration. Altogether, there were 164 celebrations in Europe, spontaneously organized. We didn't give any money for that, but we felt, I attended only 29, so it was already a lot and a fantastic experience, but it shows that the endorsement was really very wide. So for me, of course, we are providing quite substantial amounts of money now. The budget of ERC this year is over 2 billion euro. We give more than 1,000 contracts, so it's a very substantial contribution. But the point I want to make, that's my second point, is also the structural impact of the ERC, which I think is for us extremely important. I mean, us meaning the Scientific Council of the ERC, which, as you know, has the responsibility of deciding how to spend the money and how to set up the evaluation. So what do I mean by structural impact? Well, one of them, has to do with what, of course, the ERC is very competitive. Success rate this year will be around 13%, which is not much. We know preparing an application is a lot of work. But you see, now people know that in order to be successful, they have to come up really with ambitious ideas and really to give some evidence that they will be able to really achieve these ideas. And for a number of young people, and that's testimonies I heard many, many times, for many young people, it's the first time ever they were given the opportunity of saying, well, what I do, what I really want to do in the next, in the coming 5 years, and I want to explain this to people. And from that point of view, I think it really gives to a number of people, not only the young ones, of course, an opportunity to really give yourself a real objective, a real task at a certain level. And even in some countries, the fact that young people are given such such possibilities is structurally not so obvious. In a number of countries, I mean, young people have to do what their boss tells them to do. And actually, for some of them, it's the first time ever they will be given this such a possibility. So I think this is one of the impact. And of course, there are various mechanisms by which actually we make sure that this happens. One of them, which is sometimes misunderstood, is what we call portability, which means that the grant, which is won by an applicant, with a host institution, has the possibility of deciding for one reason or another to move to another organization. Actually, it's very little used, but it's really like a nuclear weapon in the hands of researchers. Because usually, if they feel that really things are not going well, I mean, sometimes because the institution abuses a little bit, and people don't want to solve the problem, if an ERC grantee tells to his president, vice chancellor, or rector, well, maybe I'm going to go, usually something happens. So it shows that the existence of portability empowers the researchers, which I think is very, very important. Now, my last point, my third point, has to do with the interdisciplinarity, which I think is something we heard today, how much to achieve a number of things, in particular curiosity-driven research. Of course, it's based on really an idea or sometimes obsession of researchers, but to really achieve things, to really make things happen, very often you have to bring together domains which previously were not so close to one another. And from that point of view, I think at ERC we know we even have to make progress on this. Most of our panels are actually already pluridisciplinary, but we know that when people are really working in fields which are truly mixing two different disciplines, it's extremely hard to get a fair evaluation. So we know we have to be working even more on that. And one initiative we took on this was to create a new type of grants. The ordinary grants are well known. They are given to one PI, principal investigator, either young or more or less young. But we reinstated the so-called synergy grants, which allows a group of two, three, or four researchers to work together. And we did that in particular with the hope, and I think it's actually happening, that really these people will be coming from different backgrounds, different fields, and they will really join forces in truly creative ways to deal with a really major scientific problems. And so I think this need to be ready intellectually to work across disciplines is very important, and to make sure that we always have with us institutions or programs, or again, I'm coming to my idea of ecosystem in which this is welcome. And this is not so obvious, because most of the academic life, I'm sure you're all aware of this, tends to be organized on different bases. That is, departments, promotions tend to be more difficult for people who have been doing different things. But I think we, from the point of view of organizations, I mean, particularly in the case of ERC, this is something we have always in mind at the level of Scientific Council, to be sure that we are promoting interdisciplinarity in the sense of just we don't have any priorities of any kind, but we want to welcome and make it easy for people who want to practice research in this way to do it and be supported by the European Research Council. Thank you very much.